no claim of responsibility, they had no serious investigative leads, and also that there was no intelligence warning that the attack would take place. Meanwhile, U.S. officials here in Washington describe this attack as, quote, coordinated and bearing the hallmarks of a sophisticated operation. A Senate source tells Fox that the Indian Mujahideen, who want Islam to dominate India's way of life, is suspect, but the group is traditionally poorly organized and probably had outside help, possibly from Pakistani intelligence.
But with a dramatic attack like this, obviously coordinated over three locations, it took money and it took planning, and that always raises the specter of the ISI in Pakistan.
And this morning, new evidence suggests that the bombs were planted at a bus shelter, also on a motorcycle, and near a parked car. This really shows that these devices were designed to cause maximum casualties, and they all went off within the span of about 15 minutes. And again, this simultaneous nature of the attacks is a signature of terrorism, Heather.
Yeah, and they did their job. So what, Catherine, what does this attack mean for the U.S.?
Well, look, immediately here in Washington, the focus went right back to 3 years ago and these attacks in Mumbai. That was a series of attacks that was orchestrated by 10 Pakistani militants who were armed simply with cell phones, handguns, and backpacks with explosives. Analysts here say that if this latest attack causes friction between India and Pakistan, that could be serious trouble for the U.S. Let's listen.
If the attack were caused to try to provoke a crisis between India and Pakistan, that would have major implications for the United States. We do not want to see those two countries go into another crisis and perhaps fight another war, which they've done three times in the past.
Context, Secretary of State Hillary Clinton still plans to go to India next week. That had been previously planned, but that trip is going ahead, Heather.
All right, thank you very much. National correspondent Catherine Harris reporting for us. Thank you.
Fox News alert and a glimmer of good news on the economic front. Weekly jobless claims are down. The Labor Department saying the number of people who filed for unemployment benefits last week fell by 22,000 to 405,000. That's the lowest level in almost 3 months. But now we're in the United States.
Heading full speed in the lane, still getting it.
never meant to take it this far. Your love for me was always new, and then the world kept turning. Time will never wait here for us. We're around here too long. We'll have to find a way to let it go and let the world keep turning. The situation's got me confused.